I did the math once. It turns out every 17.4 dinners, my family actually has a pleasant meal together.
Hey, look at this. I made a pee angel.
Oh, you're a pee angel. Stop playing with your food.
Oh, Mom.
Don't you dare.
Relax, I wasn't really going to.
Then don't.
I wasn't going to.
Then don't.
Well, don't accuse me of something that I wasn't going to do.
Interesting mood shift. It would take hours to explain the psychology behind this. So let me just put it this way. Dynamite, kid with matches.
You're going to throw that, Mom?
I wasn't going to.
Jeez, Louise. Reese.
Hell, I can handle this. Reese, I'm warning you.
I wasn't going to. But if you think I would, then maybe I should.
Oh, good. Now he's panicking.
Just put the spoon down and apologize.
Okay. She gave him an out.
Apologize for what? I wasn't going to do anything. Just stop talking. Just stop talking and let me think.
Dad, do something.
I got it.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm being cute and spontaneous.
Don't do it.
I wasn't going to.
Yep.
He's got to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night. You get up and you help him.
Yes! There's a Chucky movie on tonight.
Not in this house. You know how your father feels about evil puppet movies?
Please, Mom. It's not even a school night. I can stay up.
You really think you're old enough?
I totally am.
Well, if you really think so.
Oh, Mom, no fair.
What's the matter? Afraid you can't beat your mommy?
She's just a person. She's just a person.
Oh, no! He's finally going to win!
What's he playing for tonight?
Bedtime in a Chucky movie.
Stop screwing around. I'm pinning.
I threw rocks at him, and I killed him, and then he started flying around on rocket boots, and I got right inside his head, and now the monster's my friend, and we went to get Slurpees.
You did not! You're just lying!
Reese, if that's what Dewey says happened, there's no reason to argue about it.
No one believes I beat the last level of Mortal Kombat.
Because that's just ridiculous. No one beats Sub-Zero.
Malcolm. Malcolm. Ow! Oh! How is that even remotely fair?
That's for us all having to go to your stupid curl boy picnic today.
You think I want you to go?
A small pack of Krilloins has ventured out of hiding to bask in the afternoon sun. Their defense is down. They're an easy target for nearby predators. They sense danger, but it is too late. Their hesitation is fatal. The circle of life goes on.
Kafkaesque, isn't it?
Huh?
Never mind. Kick his butt, Alphonse.
Man, how does he do that? Totally your fault. He was right in your eye line. You don't pay attention to anything.
I pay attention.
Score! What are you doing?
Too slow.
Come on, let's just go find Dewey. This place sucks. It's hot, it stinks, nobody's t-shirts cover their stomachs, and I'm bored out of my mind.
Hey, look at that. Let's check it out.
I don't know. It doesn't just say keep out, it says forbidden.
And they wouldn't bother making it forbidden if there wasn't something totally bitching on the other side.
Wow, I can't find a flaw in his logic.
Come on. What's the worst that can happen?
We didn't do anything! I'm a diabetic. I need insulin.
Sit down.
You are such an idiot. It actually was pretty bitchin'. I'm totally getting one of these for Christmas.
I'll be Kevin. You be Clyde.
Think you can cry?
No, I gotta feel it.
Ooh. I got an idea.
No.
Just follow my lead.
No, Reese. Whatever it is, no.
Well, I guess you boys had some time to think about what you've done.
Yes, sir.
Look, I used to be your age, and I understand how tempting a place like that can be. And I guess you kids really didn't do any major harm, so I've decided to let you off.
No! You idiot! Open it! It's locked! Okay, I think I can cry now.
What seems to be the trouble here, Officer Carl?
These your boys?
Yes, sir, that they are. Fine boys. Couldn't be prouder of them.
For your information, these are two of the worst kids I have ever encountered in my life. And I work the state fair.
Really? See, that must be fascinating, seeing people from all over, the different cultures.
Hey, I don't want to be a hard case here, but these kids physically attacked me.
Uh-huh,
uh-huh. Plus, they completely destroyed a $300 pneumatic drill. What someone's going to pay for it?
Well, this all sounds pretty serious. But don't you worry, Officer Carl. They are going to hear all about it when I get them home. You see, I'm just sorry that they had to put you through all of this. That's not fair. And I fully intend to pay for...
Ah! Oh! Hi, Kevin! Get to the car!
This thing's an open casket, right?
I think so. Why?
Because I'm going to stash this with Aunt Helen.
What is that?
It's a Mighty Man. Mom and Dad had it in the back of their closet for some reason.
It's Dewey's birthday next week. This is his present.
Oh.
What'd you do to it?
I stomped on it.
Why would you do that?
Look, I don't know why I do the things I do. I just know I don't want to get caught. That's why Aunt Helen is getting a new friend.
You're gonna bury that with her?
You are so dead.
Hey, I watch lawyer shows. Mom will think I did it, but she can't prove it without this. It's in the Constitution. No evidence, no conviction. E pluribus unum.
Today, I tore this family apart, and I'm really sorry for that. But it's not half as bad as what Reese did!
Oh my God! Was this Dewey's present?
Present?
Reese, how could you? Do you know how expensive this was? Hell!
I'm on it. It was a terrible thing to do to your little brother.
There's more! He was gonna bury it with Aunt Helen.
You were gonna make Aunt Helen spend eternity with a crushed Mighty Man?
Mighty Man?
I can't believe you!
This is a whole new low, Reese.
First of all, this is all circumstantial. I don't know how that thing got in my backpack. As for this Aunt Helen business, no one knows what I would have done at that funeral because we're not going.
Who says we're not going?
You did.
Oh, well, you can guess again. You are going to march right up to that coffin and apologize to that poor dead woman. We all are.
All right, everyone in the car as is. We'll have to drive creatively, but we might make the end. Let's go, chop chop, here we go.
Have a talk.
Finally.
Well, Malcolm, you're in on this talk, too.
me. Why do I have to be here?
Relax. It's going to be far worse for me than it is for you. Boys, this talk is very important, so I need your undivided attention. It's very important that you be bored and squirm a lot. Now, I want to tell you about what happens when a boy really, really likes a girl. And Dewey, I'll try to make this easy for you to understand.
Okay. Oh, man, I still play with that.
Here we go. You see, there's a certain thing that happens between normal, healthy people. It's called chemistry. No, that doesn't happen. Except maybe the first time. What does happen is this. I like you. I like you too. And if they love each other and take the proper precautions, they'll have sex. But I've told you about that already.
Not me.
Well, ask your brothers. Now, unfortunately, if the boy is from our family, it goes a little more like this. I like you. I hate you. Now, I love you. Leave me alone. Your insane neediness is driving me away. Look at me. Look at me. Look. Oh, I'm crazy. Look what I can do. Oh, pay attention to me. Look at me. Look at me. I'm crazy. I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot. Watch me crash and burn. Ooh, ooh, ooh. There's no explaining it. It's hereditary. And it goes back for generations. Francis has it. So does Uncle Pete. It's why your great-grandpa went to work on that oil rig in Peru. All I know is your mother must carry some sort of internal antidote because, through some fluke, I was lucky enough to get her. I just wanted you boys to know what you were in for.
Wendy? Did you say something?
Wendy, I really like you. Like when a boy likes a girl, normal and healthy. I'm sorry for hurting you all those times. I'm really not a bad guy. Anyways, thanks.
I like you too.
Really?
Yeah. I even kind of liked your bad boy side too.
You. You know you're not supposed to skate in the house.
Why? Everyone else in the world gets to.
Wait a minute. Somebody stepped on something. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What a mess. Grease? What did you roll in?
Oh, man.
You have to admit it. It is kind of funny. Yelling so loud you actually throw out your back. Just try to relax. Got the baby monitor all set up here. And if you need anything, just holler. But not too loud. And I will get on it.
No! Oh, God!
Sorry.
Oh, God!
Sorry. Lois, why don't you just take the pain medicine the doctor gave you?
Because they make me loopy. I will not have this house come crashing down around me because I'm hopped up on goofballs.
Mom, I'm really sorry. Are you okay?
Oh, Reese, come to Mama. Closer, sweetheart. Are you happy you crippled your mother?
Mom.
Are you?
Mom.
So you can find cool stuff like this. Smells like gasoline.
Reese, can't we just go back to the car? My feet are killing
me. Ice cream man!
Go away! There is no ice cream in the truck!
He's lying! There's tons of ice cream in there!
The ice cream in the truck is not for sale! It is against the law for me to sell ice cream in the middle of traffic!
This is just wrong! You can make money and please children. This is a senseless act. You are evil. Pure evil!
If you kids are not willing to discuss this sensibly...
You son of a...
Look, there's nothing you can do.
Yes, there is! I can...
Hey, not so fast, Charlie!
Let go of me!
What do you think you're doing, huh?
Nothing, just going for a walk.
What the hell's going on? This kid was trying to break into your truck.
Let go of me, I just want some damn ice cream.
You don't deserve ice cream.
Yeah, well, you don't deserve to be an ice cream man.
Now! Come here, you punk, you little punk!
That will teach you to mess with me! I was a sturgeon in my country!
Pleasure doing business with you, Kyle. Nice moves out there, Aaron. And here's your share, Mr. Wells.
That man left us no choice.
Two outs, man on first. Wind up. The pitch. Uh-oh.
Oh, man. We're so dead.
That's it. Game over.
Yeah. So I win.
What?
Pass the lamp is a home run. Two men scored.
That was a foul ball.
Are you crazy? It went right down the line.
It was foul.
Shut up. You're home plate. You don't get a vote. And it was fair.
Do over.
Fine by me. Oh, crap.
Now we really have to quit.
Yeah. But that was a triple.
Get back up there.
You look very nice, Stevie.
Ah, great. Who spilled?
Oh. Ow. Circle game? I wanna play.
I don't know, Stevie. It's pretty rough.
Oh, come on, quit babying him. If he wants to play, let him play. Now remember, Stevie, don't look at this. Or this.
He's...
Hey, Reese, that's enough. This isn't funny anymore.
Okay, okay. Man. Look at your shoulders did to my knuckles. I'll get you when I come back.
I even knew.
I left. Thanks, Stevie.
I give up. I'm going to the car.
Way to go, Reese.
Ah, jeez.
Crying on command got me a cable modem.
Go ahead, hit me. Get it over with.
Ow. Let me help you reap the whirlwind.
Ow! Ow! Finally, justice.
Oh, you guys just want what's best for me, and I know that.
Oh, we do. We love you.
I love you too.
Mom, you really pissed me off when you took away my hockey stick because I was hitting Dewey with it. I know you're sorry. I'll go in the attic and take it down later.
Hey, Jeffrey. Do you need help crossing the street?
Don't worry. I'm nice now. Come on.
Jeffrey! How many times have I told you to stay out of that street? Oh, you're in so much trouble, young man.
Hello?
Yeah.
I'm here to read to you.
Okay. I was so glad when I heard you were coming.
Really? Great. I just want to help. They said the terminal patients really get a lift from this kind of stuff.
I'm sorry, did you say terminal?
I'm in the wrong room. Come to think of it, I'm in the wrong hospital.
Nurse! Nurse!
Yeah, $5.
What are you doing?
Selling my material possessions.
Why?
Because Brother Billy told me to.
Brother Billy? You mean that nut who rides around in a school bus handing out pamphlets?
It's called a manifesto. and he's not a nut once you stop and listen to him. He and his followers have this awesome compound in Oregon, where we're going to live off the land.
You're going off with this guy?
Don't worry, it is totally safe. They have guard dogs, watchtowers.
Do Mom and Dad know about this?
No, and you can't tell them. Brother Billy says they have negative energy and bad karma.
You're talking about joining a cult. Are you nuts?
Brother Billy doesn't talk like that. He makes me feel good about myself.
It's called brainwashing, Reese.
My name isn't Reese anymore.
Then what is it?
I don't remember, but it isn't Reese. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have manifestos to distribute.
Reese! You've got to help us!
What?
Your absence as a bully has created a power vacuum. Now the school is filled with rogue thugs carving out random spheres of influence. I've been hit up for my lunch money twice today.
I've been hit up 3 times. And when I didn't have anything, they took my shirt.
They took my shoes! My shoes!
Well, what am I supposed to do about it?
We need you back.
What do you mean? I was a jerk.
Yes, but you were the alpha jerk.
Reese, without you, it's anarchy. Look around you.
Give me those. Oh!
Don't you see? The whole school needs you back, administering your unique form of even-handed brutality.
You're saying my being a bully is a good thing?
Yes, you're our only hope.
Stop it! Stop it! I'm immune! Woo! I'm immune!
Hey, Stevie's off limits.
He used to be.
Get out of my way!
Ow, 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 ow!
Starting tomorrow, you're back doing my book reports.
Sure.
Let go of me! Oh, okay, I'm going.
Order. It was stopped.
To show you something. Something just for you. I have waited many years for this moment. But now that you are old enough, I want to give you something close to my heart.
Wow. Is this stuff real?
From the big war.
Wow. Is this a real gas mask?
Gas mask, yes. Field glasses. Chocolate K rations. You get yourself nice girl with this, I tell you.
This is so awesome, Grandpa. You're the best. This is so cool.
God in heaven!
What?
This is live grenade! Do not let go of handle, we both die!
I don't want to die!
Don't worry, you won't! All we have to do is find the pin! Find the pin, put the pin back in, and then everything would be fine. Quit crying like baby!
What's going on? Grandpa gave me a live grenade. It's really cool. You want to hold it?
No. Grenade's for you, not him.
Oh, my God. We have to call the police.
No, no police. No police, please. There's no reason to panic.
Yes, there is. You gave Reese a live grenade, and he's a total idiot. He's right. I am. I don't think I should have it anymore. Here.
No, you hold on to that.
No, I'm tired of this game. I think what I really want to do is go lie down now.
No. Hello!
What was that?
What was what?
Emotion.
What's Dewey doing?
He's coloring.
Well, I better get in there.
Dad!
There's this crazy guy chasing me. He's saying I did some horrible things, but I couldn't really understand him. I think he's an escapee from the mental hospital. I didn't hear anything.
Oh. Hello again, Hal.
You are not to step foot outside of this house except for school for the next month!
Okay.
Wait a minute, honey. He has to go outside. He's not done pulling weeds from his last punishment.
Oh, I think staying inside with no TV is worse than weeding.
I'm already banned from TV.
You are?
All right, fine. No TV, no going outside, except for weeding, which you'll do at night. Inside. Oh, I got nothing.
How long is this going to take?
Oh, look, just go to your room. Your father and I'll sort this out.
Okay.
We are not getting through to him.
Well, what else can we do? We've taken away television, video games, his music, fresh air. Lois, we have taken away his air, and he doesn't care about any of it.
Well, we had better come up with something before he winds up being a problem for the state.
I don't know. Maybe we should try something other than punishing him.
Like what?
Maybe Reese needs more attention, positive attention. When I was his age, I always wanted someone there to talk to hang out with, be a role model.
Oh, Hal, I don't know.
Lois, that boy needs a father figure, and I really think it should be me. You know this party's getting hotter. It's getting hotter. I'm feeling hotter. Feeling hotter. I wanna let my hair down. Gonna let my hair down.
I can't believe I really made this. You know, Dad, if you work really hard at something, it shows.
Yes, son, yes, it does.
Class, during our next session, we'll be holding a little competition. Friends and relatives are encouraged to attend. And don't be discouraged if you feel a little outclassed by some of our more promising students. We're all here to have fun.
What do I get if I win?
A 6-inch paring knife and a bread cloche.
I think he's actually gonna win.
I just hope we get to taste whatever it is he's cooking.
Reese, this is the best spinach quiche I've ever tasted. What gives it that extra something?
I put some allspice on the pine nuts before I toasted them.
Allspice?
Yeah, it just seemed like it would balance out the ricotta.
Extraordinary. How much salt did you use?
Oh, just a pinch. I did not put all of the salt in there.
Where do you keep your first aid kit? My husband's tongue is swelling up like a melon.
I need a bathroom.
Hey, Beth.
Hi, Reese.
Having fun?
I guess.
I'm kind of surprised to see you here. I mean, you're too cool to have to go to a bowling party.
Well, I could say the same thing about you.
Hey, I've got a great joke. How would you like to take a walk on the beach? Feel the salt spray in your face and the wind in your hair?
Sure, I guess.
Looks like you already have.
What's the matter with you? You spit on me, you pig.
What? Don't you get it?
Yeah, just one.
Nice roll.
Thanks. You're pretty good, too.
I've got a joke for you. Would you like to take a walk on the beach?
Reese, you're up!
Pretty good. Maybe you should help him.
Nah, I couldn't do that in front of everybody. I'm kind of his hero. Maybe just embarrass him.
That's sweet. You know, you never told me that joke.
Oh, great. Would you like to take a walk on the beach? Feel the salt spray.
Reese, you're up.
You're so cute.
Tell you that joke.
Would you like to take a walk on the beach? Feel the salt. You know what? That's not a good joke.
Mom, I don't want to do this.
Malcolm, I didn't raise you to stop trying when something is hard. You can do this. You just concentrate on those pins. You throw the ball. You are not giving up until you ball a strike.
Your mother's right, Connie.
My name's not Connie. Okay, Mom, you want to see a strike?
Malcolm, what are you doing?
Look at me. I'm the world's greatest bowler. I care so much about bowling. Bowling is so important.
Malcolm, come back here.
You want a strike? I'll give you a strike. Here's your damn strike.
Way to go, Connie. Listen, maybe you should
have been... Connie!
Oh, man, that was classic. Okay, let's go make out.
I don't think so.
Reese, get out of the photo booth!
Hi. You probably want your privacy. I'll get out of your way. Check it out. Some idiot left the storage closet unlocked. I've got every Dixie cup in the place.
What are you doing with those?
Building a future, my friend. Looks like you need a cup, friend.
Oh, that'd be great. Thanks.
I wish it were that simple.
What are you talking about? I'm thirsty.
Is that your truck out there with the canned fruit?
Yeah. Why?
Let's take a walk. I gotta tell you, Malcolm, sometimes I'm so good it's scary.
What are you doing with toilet paper?
I got my hands in some canned fruit. I traded those for batteries, the batteries for DVDs, and I swapped those with the janitor for the school's entire supply of toilet paper. Once the specially seasoned meatloaf works its magic, I can name my price.
You know, that's not only unbelievably evil, but you actually put some thought and effort into it. I'm impressed.
I don't know what it is. I guess when people are miserable and suffering, it brings out the best in me. Thanks for noticing.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Dabney, did you bring your Palm Pilot?
Yeah.
Good to know. We need assistance and ski equipment. Can I see that spear gun?
Sure.
Wait, no, this is a complete misunderstanding.
You would not.
I would too. No clothes at all. Go all the way across the street and ring Mrs. Conlin's doorbell.
Yeah, I would totally do it, but you don't have $10.
Do we?
No underwear, no clothes at all.
Of course.
What are you doing?
You said no clothes. I'll be right back, losers.
I never thought I'd do it.
I guess you outsmarted us. You opened her gate, right?
Of course.
Steve is looking for some Pam Grier memorabilia, if he can keep it here.
As long as he's got the money, the church doesn't care.
And the guy at the liquor store says he'll take the bread maker.
You know what? We're up to $159.
What do you think we should do with it?
I say we buy a saddle. Once we have the saddle, Mom and Dad can't say no to the horse.
I don't want a horse. We all worked for this. I say we vote on what we get. Do we?
Can God see everything we do?
What?
Mrs. Potts said God sees everything we do.
Yeah, Dewey. God can magically see through roofs.
What are you worried about? We're not doing anything wrong.
Then how come we have money?
Well, sometimes when you do good things happen for you.
Satisfied?
I mean, think of it this way, Dewey. People are still getting the things they need, and, okay, we do have some money. But, the church does too. So, I mean, no one's really getting hurt, and... This is bad.
I say once we get the saddle, we should just quit.
We're not getting the saddle. This was a mistake from the beginning. I should have known something was wrong when you started making so much sense.
This is your fault. You're the one that's supposed to be smart enough to keep us out of trouble. And that's why you're going to hell.
We're all going to hell.
You guys seen the remote? For...
What's going on?
Dad, we've done something terrible. It might just be the worst thing we've ever done.
All right, just calm down. Let's talk this through. It can't be that bad.
You've been stealing money from the church!
And maybe some merchandise.
Oh! Oh! Well, you boys have been taking stereos and toys! Is that cheese? Oh, God! Oh! Oh, oh my God!
Dewey, get a washcloth!
My boys are thieves!
Oh. Here, go, Dad. Oh. Nice and even.
You stole air! What is wrong with you boys? Do you ever stop and think of the consequences of anything that you do? Do you realize the shame that you're going to bring upon our entire family? Do you?
Forget that one.
Okay, ready. That is so cool. I wish you had a gun so we could really test this thing out.
Excuse me. Can I get some help here?
Hey, Craig.
So, I overheard your mom talking on the phone, and it's true. You've got a job. I applied here once. Didn't get it. It's all politics.
I guess. So what do you want?
I want you to listen very carefully. My blood sugar is dangerously low, so I don't want to burn up any calories repeating myself. I want the jumbo clown burger with the big top fries. No pickles. A slice of onion, make sure it's center cut, and extra tomatoes. And let's do the patty well on one side and medium on the other. And make sure they open a fresh package for my bun. If it's stale, I bail. Seriously.
Total's $5.45, and you get free refills in the soda.
Heard that one before. Turns out it's just for today.
What a sack.
That's a pocket transaction if I ever saw one.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Get the money?
Yeah, you'd like another 400, wouldn't you?
What are you talking about?
Wow, an entire colony of Cryphonectria parasitica.
Hey, get your own pizza, Dewey.
His name's not Dewey.
So how come you've had me call him Dewey all these years?
Look, we know you took the money and you're just trying to pin it on Reese.
After everything my brother's done for you, all the alibis, all the handouts, all the times he's helped you fake your debt.
Whoa, dudes, I wasn't even there today. The only time I came in was to cash out. You were right there.
Yeah, but I had a 10-minute break at 4:30. You could have snuck in then and taken the money.
Well, yeah, but...
You want to play innocent? Fine. We'll just let the police decide.
Whoa, police! What makes you think the cops are gonna take your side?
Maybe because you already been arrested like 10 times for petty theft.
Excuse me, one of those was for arson. I'm telling you, you're making a big mistake.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. He didn't do it. According to this citation, Richie was stopped at 4:20 today at 18th and Wilson for urinating from a moving vehicle.
So?
So, the Circus Burger is on Walnut, which is at least 25 miles away. He couldn't have gotten there during Reese's break.
Well, maybe if the traffic was light, then he...
Yeah, and maybe if a 78 Bonneville could go 300 miles an hour. Otherwise, it's impossible.
Hey, way to go, Dewey!
Let me see that. Is he right? Yes. He's always right. Sorry, Reggie. Come on, Reese, let's go.
But I swear to God, I didn't do it! I didn't take the money! Well, look, we still have a few hours. Maybe we can figure
Reggie,
out some
way. I got us the DVD player, but we need to steal another 600 if you want the surround... Sound.
You may want to hang on to that receipt.
I can't believe you lied! We're calling the cops!
Hey, maybe we can figure out some sort of deal. Whatever you guys want, it's yours.
We get to use your place for a party anytime we want.
Yeah, and we get free burgers for life.
And I get to make out with your girlfriend.
Forget it.
All right, the beanbag chair.
Gary, what are you gonna do?
This is your last warning. Pull over or you will be forced from the road.
Jackie, I have to tell you something. Just because I hate you doesn't mean I'm not sorry.
What?
I didn't mean to get you into this. It's just that I'm not, you know, I'm not very smart. So when I get in trouble, I panic, and then I do things that make it worse. I'm really sorry. And your dad is a tool.
Hey, I was just kidding about the kidnapping thing. I mean, you have enough to worry about without me being a jerk about it, right?
Wait a second. Jackie, give me your phone. I have a brother who's a total genius. He'll know what to do.
How many police cars are chasing you?
I don't know, 8, maybe 9? What are we gonna do? There's no way out of this.
Hey, don't give up. Sometimes things look their darkest right before the sun breaks. And sometimes you just have to realize that the game is over and that you've lost. The only thing left to do is to stop running, stand up, and face the consequences like a man. And... And even if the outcome is going to be more horrible than you could have possibly imagined, you can hold your head up high, show some class, and end it with dignity.
Class?
For the love of God! Not the stump rooter! No!
Where is he going?
He's turning.
The faster we're falling, we're stopping and stalling, we're running in circles again. Just as things were looking up, you said it wasn't good enough, but still we're trying one more time. Maybe we're just trying too hard, when really it's closer than it is too far.
Wow, nice. It was.
Okay, that's impressive.
Look, he's pulling over.
I think he's going to parallel park.
No way.
The spot is way too small.
He's going too fast and he hasn't given himself enough space on the right.
He did it.
Now just get out of the damn car, please.
Reese, that was amazing.
Listen. When the kids at school ask you about this, tell them I got under your bra.
I'll call the lawyer and have him meet us there.
Give him a reason. Give him a reason.
The suspect appears to be resisting. Oh, looks like they're taking out the pepper spray.
How you doing?
I'm hot and I'm bored. What is this stuff? It smells awful.
What are you doing? There's bear patches all over the place. Are you even paying attention to what you're doing?
Hey, I get grounded plenty, Ed. I know how to do grunt work. So why don't you just go fix Mrs. Conlon's garage door and get off my back?
What did you say?
You heard me.
Oh, my God. What do you know?
Everything. You might want to formulate your megabytes next time you get rid of your computer. Oh, and by the way, Mrs. Swanbeck, you are sick.
Keep your voice down. Look, it's not my fault. I try to be faithful, but the women on this block are just so desperate and lonely. It's like I cast some kind of spell. I try to tell them no, but it always leads to a back rub.
I know, Ed. I read all about it.
Is that you, Ed?
I'm a little busy right now, Martha. Look, you can't tell my wife. You can't tell anyone. Please. I'll do anything. I'll do anything you ask.
I can work with that. Where were you? I've been waiting 10 minutes for that lotion. Look at this. I'm starting to freckle.
Look, Reese, my wife gets back soon. I'm gonna have a hard time explaining why I'm catering to a 15-year-old boy.
I'll explain it to her if you want me to.
It's okay. Forget I mentioned it.
Fly.
Where?
Just a drill.
In order to break free of the Earth's atmosphere, a rocket ship must attain speeds of upwards of 25,000 miles per hour.
Bull. If they went that fast, they would just be squashed in the back of their seats. They wouldn't float around.
You're confusing acceleration with velocity. You feel it when you first start going faster, but once you're up to speed, you don't even notice. I mean, right now, we're on a planet that's spinning at 1,000 miles per hour. And that's just rotational velocity. We're also traveling around the sun at almost 67,000 miles per hour. And then, the whole solar system is hurtling through the galaxy, which is hurtling away from all the other galaxies because the universe is expanding.
He saved us all.
Yeah, it's a good thing Reese got to him before I did.
And where were you, sir?
Well, I was in bed. I actually trapped in bed. You see, my wife insists on tucking in the corners. I mean, really tucking them in.
I saw his head in the moonlight, looking like a big, fat pitch sitting over the plate.
If only there were more kids like you, our streets would be a lot safer.
Thanks.
You look familiar. Did you ever participate in our ride-along program?
Sorta.
It's like being in a straitjacket. You twist, and you just can't shake the damn sheets loose.
Well, the most important thing is we caught the guy.
You know what? Why don't I show you? Follow me to the bedroom, and I'll tuck you in.
Sir, you don't tuck in police officers.
Hey, what's going on here?
We're just playing.
It's getting a little loud. This is a nice neighborhood. Let's keep it that way. Stay in school. Hey, you kids! Where are your helmets? That's not safe.
Who the hell are you?
Watch this. Ouch. Ow. See? You should be more careful. Play safe. Be smart. Looks like someone smashed up your trash cans pretty good. Maybe if you brought them in on time, this kind of thing wouldn't happen. Hey, Mom, what are you doing?
I'm loading the groceries.
You're a little far on the sidewalk, aren't you?
Who cares? Grab a bag.
You have to leave the sidewalk free for pedestrians.
Stop stalling and help unload.
Are you walking away from me?
Excuse me?
You can't leave your car here.
I will leave my car wherever I want to leave my car.
Well, I'd hate to see anything happen to your car.
Just bring in the bags, Reese.
Dewey last time.
I'm not sure.
Officer in need of assistance. Repeat, officer in need of assistance. This isn't even fun.
That stopped being the point a long time ago.
Do You want this? Too slow. Oh. Hey, watch where you're going. Big mistake, pal. You want to go? Well, go.
Whoa, what are you doing?
He started it.
Goats don't start it. Get out.
Guess what I get to do? Leave. Go away. Get out of here. I'm warning you, I'm not falling for your goat mind games.
No, we won't. Give it up, Dewey. Superman isn't gonna fly in here and save us.
In your face, goat. Who's laughing?
Go, 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 go. Okay, kid, inside.
Open up, open up.
All right, everybody ready?
I was born ready.
Once I get my birthday money, I'll have it.
You keep your money in a book?
Yeah, it's the one place no one in my family will ever look.
Have you seen your brother? He was so
stupid. You give me a black eye, you jerk. You're gonna pay for this.
No one is paying for anything. You are gonna drop this.
Ow!
I'm sick of you two fighting. And you at least should know better. Your birthday is coming up.
I only want money.
If you want anything, you will not retaliate. I don't care who started it. It ends with you.
But he was...
With you!
You're just gonna let him have last licks?
Yes, I am. Now get out of my sight, both of you.
Seeing Reese, it was hysterical.
Are you sure you want... To push him?
It's the only way to get through to his primitive little monkey brain. He has to know that I'm not gonna back down. What is this? Oh my God.
If you can be vicious, I can be smart.
How many copies did you make?
I don't know. How many copies are there in a pack of 500 sheets?
This isn't over, Reese.
I don't know why you're so upset. Look at you going like a big boy.
Only thing that jerk understands.
Fine.
Why are you taking his side? Ooh, a birthday card. $5 Canadian. Pretty good for grandma. So, I'll have the rest of my birthday money on Saturday, so I can give you the 300 bucks for the computer win. Dear Malcolm, haha, now I win. Your friend, Reese.
Try you as an adult.
bumping. Return to the pit.
What the hell are you doing?
You had no right. You stole from me. That was my money.
Fine. Let's see. I've done 63 laps. Keep the change.
Car 8, let's be courteous.
It ends here, Reese. I don't care about the money. I don't care about my birthday. I don't care about your safety or mine. I don't care about anything except making you suffer!
Well, I don't care either.
Fine! Let's you care the least the most!
This
is a game of chicken. Reese is not gonna win! I'm too angry to blink! When he sees my face, he's gonna know he doesn't have a chance!
He's off and flying as he guns a car around the track, scamming down the pedal like he's never coming back. Adventure's waiting just ahead!
He'll stop. I know he'll stop!
Maybe this wasn't such a good...
I should have told the doctor to sew fur and tails on you boys, because you're animals! Only animals would be easier, because then I could have you fixed.
For all the good it does, you're grounded. Again.
Thanks for getting me grounded on my birthday. Oh, boo-hoo, I was grounded on my birthday. I was just standing up for myself. There is such a thing as justice, you know. Well, there is such a thing as shut up.
Stop it. Malcolm, do you remember what you did for your birthday last year?
Nothing, I was grounded then too.
And what about your birthday?
You grounded me after I smashed Malcolm's face into the cake.
And your birthday before that?
Pretty much this. Wait, when did you push me off the pony?
Do you realize that neither of you has had a birthday party in his entire life? Don't you think that's sad? Every chance you have had for a little happiness, a little something special, you threw it away. At some point, this has to stop. Is revenge ever worth it? Is it worth it now? Do you feel happy? There's no reason to compete with each other. We love you both the same. There are no favorites in this family.
Where is Dewey?
Hey, watch your driving, butt wipe!
What'd you say?
Nothing.
You better watch yourself, jerkwad. Kick your butt.
Yeah, well, I wish I had a car like that.
Thank you so much for the work you did last week. Now, I insist that you take this.
Thank you.
What work did you do last week?
Young man, nice job with those weeds yesterday. Is $5 okay?
Okay. Thank you.
No way. You didn't pull any weeds yesterday.
I know.
What's going on?
It's money day.
Money day?
Yeah, I don't know why, but it's been happening a lot lately.
Dewey, people don't have money days.
I do. It's really neat. There's also cookie days and pat on the head days. I don't like those so much. But before you know it, it's money day again.
Nice job, son.
Thanks.
Wait a minute. Why are you giving him $5?
Why? This young man cleaned out my gutters. He sorted my recyclables, and I didn't even ask him to. Couldn't find a nicer kid. I wish I could give him more.
Don't worry about it.
Can't be money day. There is no money day. I would know about it if there was a money day. Unless, maybe Mom and Dad don't want me knowing about money day.
Excuse me?
Beat it, kid. I'm trying to figure something out.
Okay, sorry. I'll just rake around you.
His name's Billy Prescott. I followed him home. He lives like a mile away from here. He looks exactly like you.
You're lying.
Am I? It's common knowledge, Dewey, that every person on this planet has an evil twin.
He's my evil twin?
Fat chance. The guy's a saint. You're his evil twin.
But I don't want to be an evil twin.
I don't make the rules, Dewey. Besides, we've been given a golden opportunity here.
To do what?
I don't know yet, but there's money and an evil twin. If we can't figure out how to make this pay off, there is something deeply wrong with us. Come on. Let's go watch some soap operas.
I don't want to do this.
If you don't do it, I'm going to tell Mom about you taking all that money, and you're going to get a me punishment. Now get to work.
Hey! What are you doing?
run Billy Prescott all the way to 1515 Cypress Street, a block west of Halifax.
Man, filling up that guy's car with cement was a stroke of genius. With Billy Prescott as our fall guy, we can do anything. Now, I've updated my enemies list. Dewey. Dewey, I'm talking to you.
Have you heard enough?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, now I know what you're thinking, but the thing that you don't realize is that I'm not the real Reese. I just look like me, him. But if you hurt us, I mean him. Oh, just go ahead. Hey, Mom, I grew an inch.
The ankles were a bit unnecessarily tight. All right, so we need to get a few of the ground rules straight. I own you. You are my property. And you should know, I don't take very good care of my things. Stand up. I said stand up! Turn around! All the way! Faster! Yeah? Take a little top. Sit down! See how that works? Cause in prison, you got to make your own fun. And when they toss in punk kids like you and you, wow, it's like Christmas for me. If you displease me, I will not hesitate to grab you by your pretty little neck, to squeeze till your eyes bulge out of your head, and then pop them with a fork. You think that's funny?
I thought you were trying to be funny.
So I got me a volunteer, huh? Well, let me tell you, Cupcakes, what your first day up in here gonna be like! And don't expect no flowers afterwards. You tough guys be pulling, well, this is where it's got you! This is... Are you paying attention?
No. I just realized, you're in prison. You're locked up in here for life. What do I need to be afraid of you for?
Because the way you is growing up, you're likely to end up in here. And when that happens, whoa, wait!
You know, Sammy, you might want to have someone smuggling some mouthwash and a cake.
Let me tell you what happened to the last guy who made fun of me. They found just enough of him to convict me.
Ooh, I am so scared of prison boy. What are you gonna do, stretch out your arms 70 miles through the bars to my house?
And you might be happy to hear that in part, because of the fine work Samuel's done with this program, he's getting paroled next week.
Hey, I don't care if you get out. You'll never figure out how to find me. Jackass.
Teapot, short, and ow! Here is my handle, here is my, ow! When I get all steamed up, hear me, ow! Tip me over and pour me, ow!
Not it.
Hello?
Hello, this is a recorded greeting from the MelgaCorp Financial
Hi,
Service.
Hi, Mom.
Congratulations.
We're fine. Okay, I'll ask him. Mom wants to know if you swept the leaves off the garage.
I'm doing it now. Leaves off my roof because I'm a mean old lady. Who cares if it's wet and slippery? The roof has to be clean because I'm stupid. Not it.
Hello? Oh, hi, Mom.
I wasn't talking about her.
What do you mean, Mom? It's me, Francis. Did you page me?
Yeah, Reese is right here. I'll tell him, Mom, but does he really have to stay up all night? Can't he fix my bike tomorrow? Well, you're right. Saturday morning is the best time for riding.
Okay, now I get it. Just go easy on him. You're a lot smarter than he is. I gotta go.
My bed's going in the sunny spot, and Reese's bed is going in the closet like you wanted.
This is ridiculous. We're never gonna make that movie.
I'm moving as fast as I can, okay?
He's doing a really good job, Mom. You may want to give him a break.
Thanks, Dewey. You're a good brother.
She said no.
Don't you think it's a little strange that your mom keeps calling just so you can do Dewey's homework and fix Dewey's bike and move Dewey's furniture around?
What are you trying to say?
It's obvious, isn't it? She wants you to do stuff for Dewey.
Hey, if you want to talk to her about it.
As a matter of fact, I do. Hello? Yes, good afternoon to you, too. Well, thank you, but I really don't need to know what time it is. Just... Wait, listen to me! Listen to me!
Forget it. There's no talking to her.
Goodbye. Okay, good afternoon. God, she's polite and rude at the same time.
Yeah, Mom. You just finished digging that underground fort you wanted. I think you're gonna have a lot of fun in it.
Give me that. Honey, don't say anything. Just listen. You were right. You're always right. From now on, I will do whatever you say because I have been happier just mindlessly obeying you than doing what I think I want with any of my so-called friends. I love you. I miss you. Here's Dewey.
Really, Mom? You want me to cut Reese's hair? But he loves his hair. Okay.
This is so unfair. Just get it over with.
Mohawks are kind of out, Mom. What if I... Do you hear a strange ringing, Mom?
You are so dead!
That you can't stand anyone else getting any attention. Your brother has worked so hard to make this yard sale a success, he doesn't need you undermining him at every turn.
Mom, you have to listen to me. We have a Nortair 680B. It's a type of computer that was built in 1976. There's only a few in existence, and Craig is gonna give us $1,300 for it.
$1,300? Oh my God! What are you doing?
I have a lot of things to sell, and I don't have time to argue with this bozo. I've got a jet ski on hold, and the place closes at 6.
What are you talking about?
I'm buying a jet ski with my yard sale money.
That money isn't yours. He's going to rebuild our bedroom wall.
But you said I was in charge. That means I get the money.
No, it doesn't.
Then why the hell would I want to be in charge?
Reese, this is helping you become a better person by building your self-esteem, which you are obviously going to need if you are stupid enough to throw away $1,300 that this family desperately needs.
It all became clear to me that first day in church. And now that everything has been carefully prepared, this will be the most magnificent day of my life.
What are you doing?
I plan to float above the clouds and experience a joy that only birds can know.
You're gonna fry yourself on a high voltage wire.
I'm not afraid. I have faith in my vision. I love you, Dewey. This is incredible! I can see the top of Dad's car from here!
I'll miss you at first! No, I'm as surprised as you are.
Amazing Race! How sweet the taste that saved a wrench for me! I once was in the lost and found, was blind but found my keys.
My just joined us 2 weeks ago.
Believe me, you do not want us to be part of your church.
We really don't belong around civilized people. Oh, come now, I'm sure that's just a... See? That's exactly the kind of thing we're talking about.
I'll cause a distraction. You go in the kitchen and get Gorda.
I'm bigger!
again, we're very sorry about all the trouble we caused. I know there's no way we can make...
Try the party out on the pier!
What parties? Who are these people? Do we even go to the same school?
Stop rocking my boat.
Let's just walk home, take a horrible punishment from Dad, and be done with it.
What are you talking about? These girls want to fool around with us.
Only because we're losers.
Hey, we're riding in a limo we didn't pay for. We're about to make out with hot girls who don't even like us. I don't know what we are, but we are not losers.
Have you even thought about where this is going? Her boyfriend is Aaron Stepanovich. Have you seen that guy? If he sees you kissing his girlfriend, he's gonna kill you.
I know.
Then why are you...
Because anything's better than the way things are now. Look, I've had this cute lab partner in science for 8 weeks now.
Her name is Cheryl. I finally left Cheryl a note on her desk asking her out. And when she read it, she turned to me and said, "Do you know who Reese is?" So then she goes, "Does anybody know who Reese is?" And everybody shrugged.
So then I said, "Probably some nobody." And you know what? I was right.
Wow. That's awful, kid. You want to wear my hat?
So tonight, I'm going to fix that. From now on, when I walk by, people are going to say, "What happened to that guy's face?" Someone's going to say, "That's Reese. He made out with Aaron Stepanovich's girlfriend." And that I can live with.
Well, this is the turkey you got?
It's perfect.
It's really small.
Well, if it were any bigger, it wouldn't be able to fit inside of this.
What, you're gonna put our dinner inside that monster?
It's a monkfish. The juices of the monkfish will baste the turkey. The flavor from the turkey will saturate the fish, both melding into one fantastic dish.
Reese, this doesn't seem like a good idea.
I don't know, Dad. Maybe you're right. Maybe I have no idea what I'm talking about.
Oh! You know, that really shouldn't work.
Listen, my ugly beauty. Yesterday, you were sucking scum off the bottom of the sea. Tonight, you're gonna tango with the gods.
Yes, master. I will be delicious for you.
Dad, what are these?
Minced onions.
Minced. I specifically asked for diced. Come on, Dad.
Don't take that tone with me, Reese.
This isn't fun.
Fun? No, Dewey, this is not fun. Neither one of you seems to understand. We are not playing games here. There are lives at stake.
No, there aren't.
Okay, but it's very important. We're creating something special. Something great. Something beautiful.
Where's my wallet in my other pocket?
Can we stay focused, Dad?
There was $80 in here.
I had to. The cheese course was a joke.
Reese, you are in big trouble. And you know what? I have had it with this. I'm through. With the helping part. I'm still doing the eating part.
Fine, go. I don't need you. I still have Dewey. He's twice the assistant entremetier that you'll ever be.
What is all this stuff?
Piano, good, I need you. Here, stir this pot. All right. I just have to stuff the acorn squash rings with roasted pepper and polenta, sear the scallops with... the monkfish! Where are the other mitts?
You want me to look?
No, keep stirring. No placemats, no tea towels. I need something.
I'll get a towel from the bathroom.
No, there's not enough time. It has to come at exactly 5:38. Not 5:37, not 5:39.
What are you gonna do?
There's only one thing I can do.
Reese, no!
Yes! Leave me a space!
Where?
Move the oven mitts!
There, that's it. I made your bed every day for a year.
Wow. Congratulations, I can't believe you actually did it.
And according to our deal, that means from now on, I get to sleep in this bed.
That wasn't exactly our deal, Dewey.
Yes, it was. You promised that if I did it, I'd get to bed every day after that.
Right. Every day. But I still get it at night.
That's not fair!
I don't know, Dewey. His case sounds pretty solid to me.
Oh, and Dewey, I don't want to ruin it by being too specific, but something you wear now has some kind of creature in it.
Jamie needs a change.
I want to do it!
No way! We're supposed to take turns!
Mom told us Jamie swallowed one of her diamond earrings. Whoever finds it when it comes out gets a 20-buck reward.
Let Reese change this one. He hasn't gotten to in a while.
Oh, man.
Somehow they never notice that Mom doesn't own any diamond earrings.
Smells like my ticket to Easy Street.
Well, Dewey, most people go through life unnoticed. Their names are never in the paper. They've got no laws named after them. That's fine for most people, but I wanted more. Hey! It's not always easy. You don't make a lot of friends being unpopular.
Someday we'll all get even with you, Reese.
Huh.
What is it?
That kid just gave me the best idea of my life.
Been in our cesspool for a month. I think he lives on poo.
Where is it?
Hello, everyone. Don't worry. If I wanted to beat you up, you'd all be hanging by your underpants by now. I've gathered you here to make you an offer.
What kind of offer, Reese?
I'm glad you asked, Dewey. It's no secret that I've tortured all of you over the years. Some of you have scars on the outside. Some of you are damaged in places we can't see. Each one of you wants revenge. And you know what? You're entitled to it.
Gee, Reese, revenge sounds great. But how could we accomplish that?
Another good question, Dewey. For 20 bucks, I'll let each one of you beat the hell out of me for 30 seconds.
Boy, Reese, this is tempting. But how do we know you won't let us hit you today, but then get even with us tomorrow?
That's the beauty part. I'll be tied up and blindfolded the whole time you're beating me.
Wow.
The line will form at the garage in 1 hour. I'm not going to tell you how to get the money. Your mothers all have purses. Except for you, Freddy. Your mother...
What about pulling Reese's hair?
No, his head will be covered. Look, you're thinking too hard. Just let your hatred tell your body what to do.
How are we doing?
So far, 23 kids have signed up. We've taken in $460.
Oh, my God.
Just remember, we gotta save 20 bucks for the cab ride to the hospital.
I'm gonna get the crap kicked out of me for money. This is the greatest nation on earth.
Seconds. Absolutely no weapons of any kind. All right, let me go see if he's ready. Reese, it's time to start. Here's our first secret anonymous customer.
It's Bobby Markovich.
Not so hard! Don't hurt my brother!
Okay, you. Your time is up.
Hey!
Reese? What are you doing up there? Who's this?
Some kid I found on the street. I don't know his name.
Chad.
Sorry, man. How could you hit me like that? You're my brother and my partner. And you didn't pay! Savoring the greatest achievement of a life that so far has had some pretty mixed results. Get in.
What exactly do you think you're gonna accomplish in a car with no engine?
There's a kegger down at the field. They've been without us long enough.
Reese, you're insane.
Yeah, you can make an argument for that.
Hello, 24-hour party people!
Reese, you moron. I can't believe you think you're gonna get away with
it. Cool car.
65 Mustang.
Yeah, driving's cool. I do all my thinking when I drive. Of course, sometimes I drive and I don't think. I just drive. But no matter where I drive or how much I drive, I find that people are still people.
That is so true. Thanks for letting me wear your jacket.
Sure. Let me ask you something. Do you remember last week when I said hello to you and you said, look what's trying to talk to me?
did I?
So, are you nicer to me now because you realize we have more in common than you thought? Or because you find our differences intriguing? Or because now I have a car?
Probably the car.
Cool. Sometimes I love high school.
Hey, why don't we drive somewhere so we can have a little privacy?
I don't see why we have to drive anywhere. It's a beautiful night. I'm with a beautiful girl. There's some beautiful bushes over there.
I'll get some blankets. Come on, Olivia.
You are a god. A god of a special universe where no one thinks of consequences and where those of us constrained by intelligence and common sense are not allowed. But you have invited me in. And from now on, I will follow you anywhere.
Hey, hey, hey! This cop car's up at the top of the hill. Everybody get out of here! Move your damn car!
Huh?
I think the battery's dead. I'll jump it! Hey! Somebody stole our engine! Nobody's going anywhere until they give it back! I'm glad the cops are coming!
All right, Jamie. This'll put a stop to all the stealing. And your father is a reasonable man, but sometimes even he can be pushed too far. You don't poke the bear. Hey, somebody move! We have a warrant to search these premises on suspicion of possession of narcotics. Nice.
Narcotics? What are you doing?
Sir, we need you to just remain calm and we'll get through this as quickly as possible.
Weren't you Annie Oakley in the school play?
Yeah, but I wasn't very good.
You were just using me to get to my dad? And all this time you were selling drugs and you never even bought us a DVD player? Get him out of here.
Mom? Thank you so much. There you are.
What in the name of God were you thinking?
Look at you! You are filthy! Your nails are a disgrace! You've been tomb robbing! Well, the fun stops now, young man. Oh, you are in so much trouble.
Dewey, could you reach into my sock drawer with your hand and get me a pair of socks?
Okay.
Not that one, on top. Not on top of the dresser, right in front of you, the sock drawer. That's your sock drawer. Go next to it. On the other side. Not behind the dresser. All you have to do is reach into my drawer and... Ow! So stupid, Dewey! Hey, go ahead!
Reach! What are you doing? Come on!
Possibly, let me out.
No, not now. This is Daddy's time with Reese.
Are you sure this is a good idea?
Dewey, I don't need you talking sense to me right now. Reese, quit screwing around.
Yeah!
fix my own. Peanut butter's good too. Nothing wrong with having peanut butter.
What?
Just because I'm having ham doesn't mean you have to have ham. Just because we're brothers doesn't mean we have to enjoy the same thing, right?
Exactly. Everybody's different. It'd be stupid if I tried to force you to like something I liked.
Right. Plus, it wouldn't work anyway. People can't help what they like. That's just the way they're born.
I know. Like me. I've never liked ham.
Really? Because maybe if you tried it...
No. But that's me. I'm not putting it down or anything.
I hear you. There's no right sandwich. So, the ABBA thing.
Should be great.
Yeah, absolutely. Just great. Hey. Have a good snack.
You too.
Like that.
Yeah, nothing creepy about it at all.
You guys want to listen to the CD again?
Again? Oh, yeah. Love ABBA.
I could listen to it forever.
If you change your mind, take a chance on the first in line. Take a chance, take a chance, honey, I'm still free. Take a chance, take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Take a chance, 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 take a chance.
What'd you think of the Versace?
Well, it has a nice drape, and it seems like a kicky look for fall.
Yeah, I think it's yummy.
Okay, you know what? This is stupid. We have to talk about this.
Right. I mean, just because it's weird doesn't mean we can't handle it. We're brothers.
Right. We've been through everything together. We shouldn't be pussyfooting around about it. I got you something.
Hey, I got you something.
Really? See, this is what I'm talking about. We're being open and supportive and honest with each other. Here.
What's this?
It's called If You're Gay, It's Okay. It's full of great resources. What's this?
Naughty Pool Boys 3. I watched 10 or 12 of these, and this one seems to have the most stuff you guys like.
Wait. I'm not gay, you're gay.
No, I'm not. You are.
I'm not gay.
Malcolm, check out what they're doing in that movie and then tell me you're not gay.
No, this is... She said...
Sleep right next to the toilet. See you guys at dinner.
Vendetta. How could you be so...
Vendetta!
Yes, Vendetta. Reese, I promise we'll get back at her. But we have to be careful. She's got Mom totally on her side.
Oh, yeah.
It's tricky. Somehow we've got to figure out a way to turn Mom against her.
Okay, got it.
What?
It's a little risky, but I'll tell you one thing. No one calls me gay and gets away with it.
Crap!
Pick ass O.
What? What is it? We've got something for you. Dewey and I finally came up with something good enough for that insane voice in your head.
Here, put this on first.
Roman candles?
Well, that's how they start off. We decided to give them a little more oomph. Do you care if you keep your eyebrows?
Hell no! Okay, the fuse is timed for 20 seconds. You're gonna light it, and then get up on the board, and jump. The rocket should kick in around there. They won't give you any momentum, but they will ignite that. Hopefully, you will land in that kiddie pool.
We think that's got a 50-50 shot of putting you out. If the roof doesn't collapse. Or ignite.
And it's all gonna be caught on that video camera. It has a direct feed to the internet. You're the featured page on GiantJackass.com. This is more than anything I could have ever asked for. Nobody deserves it more than you. He would have wanted us to wait.
Good boy, you finished all your peas.
Hey, slugger. Guess what? The clinic called. They said my ass was a perfect match for your hand. They can start the skin grafts next week.
Reese, what do you think you're doing?
What? He loves the stuff. He goes with 3 or 4 cans a day. I don't know how he does it. Half a can makes me nuts. Craig, I'd like to welcome you to the first day of your new, more vicious life. I give you the human body. For clarity, we've divided it into the 3 major theaters of operation. The head, the torso.
And what are those?
You know what those are. Now, the first thing you need to know is that this is all about pride. Do you have pride, Craig?
Yes.
Okay, that is not the answer I was looking for. You show me a man with pride, and I'll show you a man with limited options. Let's say that this is your opponent, and he's coming after you. Hey, man! We can work this out! I didn't know she was your girl! See? Now he's blind, and he had the time to really get creative. Personally, I like to leave at least 1 sense intact so he knows what's happening to him.
I knew I came to the right place.
Okay, Dewey. You're up.
Disgusting! Ah!
Is he going for the plums? It appears so. Well, you sure won't have to worry about the guy's children?
Well, I wonder which nightmare I'm gonna have tonight. The forest of severed legs or drowning in grandma's blood. Well, good night.
I'm gonna sleep like a baby tonight. Me too. Nothing's gonna wake me up.
Same here.
Well, good night.
Good night.
What's under your pillow?
What's under your pillow?
I think we both know what's under these pillows.
I guess we do.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I feel great. Ready to start the day.
Me too. Think I'll brush my teeth.
I'll join you.
I haven't slept in 2 days. I cut school just to have some time in the house without Reese. I just need an hour. A half hour. Any sleep at all. Then I'll have a jump on him. You can't win this on strength. You've got to win it on planning.
Ah! 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 You saved yourself this time, but your reactions will get slower. And I'll be waiting. Wait, this is so stupid. We're both ruining our lives over it. I got a B on my history midterm.
I fell asleep beating up a kid.
We have to stop this.
I totally agree.
Okay. Truce. Truce. I got into this thing with Reese, and it's way out of hand. I haven't slept in 3 days. If you could just do me a favor, just be on the lookout for Reese. If I can get 1 hour of sleep, then I can have the upper hand, and I can end this.
Okay.
Thank you. Wait a minute. Why'd you say okay?
What?
I mean, I just told you, and you said okay like it wasn't a big deal. It seems like you'd at least want to think about it for a little bit. Unless this was a setup. That's what this is, isn't it?
What's going on in here? What are you guys up to?
Oh, nice cover. You do have a side deal.
No. Or maybe you're just trying to make me think we have a side deal.
Why would I do that?
Exactly.
Don't try to make me think that you're confused, because I know you aren't.
Why would I want you to think that?
Because there's some angle that I'm not seeing, but I'll get it.
Nice bluff.
Nice fake out.
Oh, yeah? Well, you can play all the smart games you want, but I'm not going to let you get away with it. I'll glue my own face to the floor. Then what are you going to do, huh?
That'd be the perfect way to make me let my guard down, wouldn't it? Ha! Ha! Ha.
Stevie, I know you'll be mature enough not to do anything I would do.
Jennifer, cut it out. So bad. Your breath smells like feet.
No, Reese, you're not coming in here with those.
But they'll freeze to death out there!
I'm sorry, son. I already promised your mom I would get rid of them. And I have 4 or 5 other lies in the fire I can't jeopardize. The bugs stay outside.
Fine. Then I'll fight you for it!
Reese, you already fought me for the last English muffin 2 weeks ago, and I cleaned your clock.
But this time, I fight for something I love even more than those muffins!
Keep your voice down. You're gonna wake Jamie.
Good! I want him to hear what kind of heartless monster his father really is. Come on, old man. Let's go.
All right, but if I throw my back out again, beating you up, I am gonna kick the crap out of you.
Man, that was amazing! They won't be leaving any more messages on our side of the park. Where are we going now, Lucky? Huh? Lucky, where are you leading us? Really? You guys mean it? All right, I won't let you guys down. Let's roll!
You found him in a chicken coop?
Well, it's hard to know exactly what happened, ma'am. He and his friends appeared to have had themselves quite a little party. They just don't train you to handle a scene like that. The law's a little murky in this area, but when we figure out how to charge him, I'll be back.
I never thought about how it would end. It just felt so cool to belong.
The important thing is you're out.
But my boys, they rounded us all up. Then these vets came in, and one by one...
They killed them?
No. They're not my boys anymore. Okay, I'm ready.
For what?
Whatever it is you do with beautiful people. I'll give you 20% and not a penny more. You may have to travel because I'm gonna have a house in Miami, Milan, and at Disney World in France.
You're welcome to fly my private jet, but I want you to keep it real. I'd also like a Falcon.
What are you talking about? I can't do anything with you.
What? Why not? I read the book. I measured everything. I'm perfect.
It's true. You do have the perfect features for a middle-aged woman. If you want to, have a sex change. Come back in 20 years and we'll talk.
Ugh. No! Please, this can't be how it ends. I'm supposed to have 3 rocky marriages and die in a hotel fire. Don't send me home. I'm too perfect to live like a person. Boxes of cereal, 2 gallons of milk, 8 peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, adult diapers, and Mad Libs.
I thought of everything.
And I also packed some barbells so I could get there in fighting shape.
They look like soup cans.
You noticed? See, there's a lot of things that serve 2 purposes. Like my pillow. It's stuffed with M&Ms so I can sleep and snack from the same source. It's the same way NASA designed the old space capsules.
The very same.
And you'll be ready with the tapes to cover with Mom, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's get moving. I want to be at the post office for the 4 o'clock pickup.
Should I get you stamped fragile?
What's that supposed to mean? And the journey begins. Day 23. I'm out of food. But I've never felt so focused and alive. I see everything now with crystal clarity that... Day 24. I must be getting close. I can smell the docks. Listen, Lyle, I'm as lost as you are. I may not even graduate high school. I'm completely broke. If I disappeared, who would notice? But now I've got a purpose. Maybe you and I were meant to talk today.
You mean like fate?
Exactly. Maybe life is like a roller coaster, and you only go down to get fun coming back up.
Maybe. Wow, I actually feel a little better.
Now, this is what I want you to do. I want you to walk into the bathroom, and I want to hear you flush those pills down the toilet.
They're gone. I did it. Oh! I don't know what to say, but thank you, Reed. Thank you.
Don't thank me, Lyle. This is all you. You should feel good about yourself for what you did today. You should treat yourself to something really nice. Why don't you take out your credit card and buy a dozen air purifiers?
Well, that sounds a little expensive.
I just saved your life and now you're questioning me?
Well, look, I'm sorry, I was just saying...
Every minute I'm talking to you, the price is going up. I want those numbers now, do you hear me?
Let me find my wallet.
Just give him the damn TV.
You're a really good dancer.
When I'm with you, it doesn't even feel like we're dancing. It's like we're floating.
I misjudged you, Reese. I just chose you because you weren't completely hideous and I knew you wouldn't have a date. But you're so much more than that. You've made me feel wonderful.
It's been a really great night for me, too. You helped me find a little part of me that I didn't even know was there. The part that isn't a gigantic jackass.
You know, I wasn't planning on the night ending this way. Why don't we get out of here? Grab a blanket and a bottle of wine. Go to the beach.
You mean it?
Yes, Reese. I really want you.
Oh, wow. It's 12 o'clock already? Too bad, I was having fun. Well, I'll see you at school.
Reese, where are you going?
It's midnight. I'm off the clock.
But what about us? And all those things you said?
Well, if I want to make a career out of this, I've got to satisfy my customers. And I think I did. Tell your friends.
So, right when we walk in, I fake a seizure. When I fall, I make sure my skirt comes up over my hips. I'm going commando, so you'll have plenty of time to sneak this out of the car.
I love you, Grandma.
You're a good boy.
What's that noise?
Nothing, Dad. Just a little hungry.
All right, Malcolm, I know you're angry. You might as well say what you have to now and get it out of your system.
Boom!